babes, welcome back. I hope you're all well. So in today's video, I thought I would share like my favorite luxury items in my collection right now. I feel like I've done a similar video in the past, but I got some new things that I've been loving. Some of the stuff that I'm gonna be talking about today is older and I've had for a while, but others are newer items that I'm just digging right now and I thought I would share them with you guys. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. Okay, let's start off with sunglasses. I feel like I've mentioned these before also, by the way, obviously. I'm not gonna be talking like just about bags. These are gonna be luxury items in general, just things that I love. So these sunglasses, I think I've talked about them before, but they are Celine. They're older. I've had them for a long time now. They used to be like super popular. I'm not a huge sunglass person, but these I really love. They are probably my number one, yeah, like go-to sunglasses. I wear them with almost every outfit. I just think they're amazing. I did sit on them though at some point, so they are a little bit crooked, but I'm just gonna show you what they look like on my face. I should have probably cleaned them, but I don't look good with sunglasses in general. Like, there are few sunglasses that look good on my face. I do like how these look. I think they're okay on my face, but most importantly, they're really comfortable. My eyelashes don't, you know, hit on them. They don't feel like weird on my nose. I had my nose broken a long time ago, which, so it is a little bit crooked. I never had it fixed. And so sometimes when I have sunglasses, they kind of sit a little crooked, and these don't do that, so I absolutely love them. But yeah, I think they're beautiful, and even if they're not like super trendy anymore, I still think they're absolutely amazing. Let's move on to shoes, because you guys know I love shoes. I am obsessed, and if you don't know, then that probably means that you're not usually here. So if you're new, you should definitely hit that subscribe button down below if you like these types of videos. I make videos on luxury everything, like everything about luxury, all the time. So yeah, if you like these types of videos, come on over and hang out with us. So let's start off with the first pair of shoes. Chanel slingbacks. Also have had these for a while. I just recently ruined them a little bit here on the inside. I don't know what I did, but I think I wore them when it was snowing out and got like salt on them. I don't know why I do things like that, guys. But anyways, they're meant to be worn, so whatever. I'm not gonna cry over it. I love these. I've talked about them before, but just recently, like sometimes even if I don't like, if I didn't purchase something new, I still might like re-fall in love with it. Like these sat in my closet for a while and I didn't really wear them. And then, I don't know, the last couple of months I've just been reaching for them and I really like them. And I love styling them really edgy, but I think I said that before. So really been loving these. And then another pair of shoes, which I never even showed you guys, are these right here. They are the Dior slingbacks. I actually bought these in New York. And I know I never even did a Dior haul. I mean, not a Dior haul. A New York City haul. I don't know why I didn't do that. I just totally forgot about it, I guess. And then I started wearing all the stuff and I was like, well, too late now, Angelique. But anyways, I bought these while I was in New York and I'm really happy that I got them. I love them. I just needed like a nude pair of heels and I thought these would be perfect. I already have them in blue and I love those as well. But yeah, I just wanted a more, I don't know, I guess wearable color. So I've been loving these. These are absolutely amazing and they go with everything. You guys knew it was coming, the Prada re-edition 2005. This is an amazing bag. Talked about it so much already. It had to be in this video. I honestly cannot tell you guys how perfect this bag is. Even my son said to me a couple days ago, he's like, Mom, you really love this bag. And I have quite a few bags and he's never said that before. I just reach for this all the time now and I can't believe I'm about to say this, but if I couldn't like have any of my other designer bags, or if I could only have maybe two or three, I think I would definitely choose this, even though I know it's trendy, but that's not why I love it. I just, yeah, obviously I fell in love with it because I loved how people were styling it and just the way it looked, but it's just such an amazing bag. It's just so cool. Like, I don't even know how to explain to you guys how much I like this. And so many of you have told me and messaged me and said like that you didn't even really like it or you weren't that interested in it and that I showed it to you guys and like styled it and stuff. By the way, follow me on Instagram if you don't already. And now you love it too. And then some of you have already purchased it and you love it. I just think it's a great bag. Like, it is really a great bag and I'm here for it. I am here for it. Even if it's no longer popular, I will be rocking this every single day. This bag will never, ever, ever leave my collection. I'm gonna say that I love this as much as I do my YSL Collège bag, and you guys know how much I love that bag. But this is definitely equally as good. Totally different bag, but I freaking love it. I love it. It's just so me. It's 100% me. And then another thing I wanted to tell you guys about this bag. I spilled coffee all over it the other day. So I had coffee in my car in my cup holder, and I don't know what I did, like I turned or something, and it like kind of tipped over and it went all over my bag. I just took a baby wipe and wiped it down. Like, I didn't have to panic or anything like that, which if I would have had another bag sitting there, it would have probably sucked, but it's just so easy to take care of. Next up, let's talk about this YSL card holder. I feel like I don't give him enough love, and yes, he's a him. I talked about card holders in my previous video, which if you haven't seen that, I'll leave it linked down below. But so many of you asked which like my favorites are, and I don't want to really talk about my other card holders because they don't compare to this one. I love this card holder. It is simple, it is sleek, it looks elegant, and I absolutely love it. I love the logo. Like, I'm a logo person, so I really like that. I don't mind that it's silver. I love mixing my like silver and gold, and it's just, ever since I've bought this, and that, oh God, when have I bought this? At least 2 years ago, if not longer, and I have not switched out of it since. Love, love, love this card holder. I'm not saying that I'll never switch out of it, but I have no desire. If it falls apart, then I will. But other than that, love this. So good. Last but not least, I want to talk about a makeup product. I don't talk about makeup much here on my channel, but I thought, why not? This is a primer from Sisley. It's about $200, and I know that sounds absolutely crazy, and you're probably like, Angelique, what the hell are you doing recommending a $200 freaking primer to us right now? Get it together. But I swear I wouldn't recommend something to you that I didn't believe was worth it, okay? So here's the thing with this primer. It lasts forever. Literally will last you forever. I've had this for probably, I don't know. I've had it for such a long time. And it still has stuff left in it. Like, there's still product in it, but it really is so good. I will never go back to another primer. And if you think about it, if you buy a primer that's like $40 and you have to get a new one every like month, it adds up. And this one really lasts a long time because you only need a small amount, and it feels so good on your skin, and it almost makes it look airbrushed. I have really weird skin. Sometimes it's dry, sometimes it's oily, sometimes it's both. And so I usually put it in this area right here where I feel like my pores are larger, and I also put it on my forehead, and it just helps my makeup stay on longer. But most importantly, my makeup looks a lot smoother if I have this on underneath. And I don't use this all the time. I typically put it on when I film, and I put it on if I go out. But if I'm like just going to work or running errands or something like that, I don't use it. But I just noticed such a difference. So I wanted to tell you guys about it because I don't think I've ever really talked about it. It's an amazing primer. How did I find out about this? I think Jeffree Star, something like that. I watched one of his videos and he was talking about this. I'm like, really? A $200 primer? But also what I wanted to say is, I mean, don't go out and like buy this right away. Maybe get a sample or something like that if you don't want to spend the money. And see how you like it. That's what I did. I got a sample first. Sample lasted forever, and I was so in love with it. I remember the first time I put it on my face, I was like, holy smokes, this is absolutely amazing. And then I went out and bought it. So yeah, you can always ask for a sample. Remember that, guys, with any makeup products, you can always ask for samples. That is it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and give it a thumbs up if you liked it, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.